tonight on NewsWatch, crisis in Ukraine. Could pro-Russian protests lead to civil war?
Plus, women in combat. A look at the military's push to put women in frontline roles.
And Boston Strong. How forgiveness is helping people heal 1 year after the Boston Marathon bombings. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. And good evening, everyone. I'm George Thomas.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. Reports tonight of gunfire and tanks on the move in eastern Ukraine, bringing tensions there to a new level.
Yeah, very much so. And that comes as the government in Kiev is cracking down on pro-Russian protests in several cities. As John Waggy explains in tonight's top story, it's a move that could trigger a show of force from Moscow.
Ukraine sent an armored column to the city of Slavyansk near the Russian border, where supporters of Moscow had taken over police headquarters and set up their own checkpoints. Acting Ukrainian President Oleksandr Turchynov announced his government's first military action, what he called an anti-terrorist operation in eastern Ukraine. In Kiev, angry anti-Russian activists attacked a pro-Russian presidential candidate as he was leaving a TV station. Earlier, another sign of tension as a Russian jet buzzed a U.S. Navy ship in the Black Sea. The jet reportedly made a dozen high-speed passes over the USS Donald Cook for more than 90 minutes.
The message is, we see you, we don't like you in our backyard, and we prefer that you would leave.
It's just one more instance of Russian President Vladimir Putin thumbing his nose at President Obama, who is now more known for his tough talk than forceful action. When the president and Putin spoke for 90 minutes Monday, the White House expressed grave concern over Putin's support for pro-Russian militia destabilizing eastern Ukraine. The U.S. fears Kiev will have no choice but to use force and has pointed a public finger at Putin.
We know who is behind this, indeed the only entity in the area capable of these coordinated professional military actions is Russia.
The administration says tough economic sanctions are beginning to take hold and is threatening to ratchet them up if Russia doesn't back down. But Putin is leveling his own sanctions against Ukraine. He's more than doubled the price of natural gas since the pro-Russian Ukrainian president Yanukovych was ousted in February. That makes life much tougher for Yuri Kuleshov and his wife Svetlana, pensioners who live near Kiev. Kuleshov says, we will simply stop buying all the things we are buying now because we have to heat the house in order not to freeze. President Obama says he has no plans to send weapons to Ukraine. John Waggy, CBN News.
Sergei Rakuba of Russian Ministries joins us now for more. Sergei, as we speak, Ukrainian forces are moving against pro-Russian separatists in the east. What are your concerns right now?
You know, we're getting lots of concerns about our families and our co-workers' families, about churches that are in that area. And as you've seen probably on the news, some of the glimpses of the reports, but we see that the tension is not just growing. There is already fight. There, the blood was spilled. And as we see, so that new Ukrainian government, interim government, made an order to move in and start pushing out those separatists, though they look like very well-equipped special forces, speak with a good Russian accent, are blocking those administration buildings in all those towns.
And to that point, Sergei, I mean, the Russians don't necessarily need to move their tanks across the border. They can just send these special forces that don't wear any insignia, and they're relying on them to create the chaos, right?
And that's as we see what happened in Crimea, so that identified soldiers took over the building. Then they sent lots of propaganda. They created lots of local pressure and raised and falsificated some results. And the Crimea was annexed within the couple of weeks. So that's the same strategy, the same tactics we see is used in eastern Ukrainian regions of Lugansk, Donetsk, Kharkov, and even they're expanding now farther to Kherson and Poltava. So this identified soldiers, they call them a little green man, well-trained, well-equipped, armed. So they're taking over these buildings and then invite local separatists to mixed with them, and then they demand the Ukrainian government to giving into their ideas and demands of eastern Ukrainian regions to separate itself from the mainland of Ukraine.
Let's talk about the situation in Crimea. As you know, there are close to about 250,000 refugees, mainly Muslim Tatars. You are reporting that there are thousands that are fleeing Crimea. Can you tell us about that?
And there were some Catholics and Orthodox leaders that are fleeing themselves from Crimea today. And Catholic leaders, Catholic priests, they say they cannot stay there because they received the multiple threats on their lives and their families.
Sergei Rakuba of Russian Ministries, as always, sir, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much, George.
Well, today marks the one-year anniversary of the Boston Marathon bombings. Thousands of people are coming together to honor victims of the attack. Vice President Joe Biden took part in a ceremony in Boston, and from the White House, President Obama observed a moment of silence at 2:49 p.m., that's the exact time the first of the two bombs exploded at the marathon finishing line. And although some survivors stayed home to mark the day privately, others joined the ceremony to remind the world they are Boston strong.
Next Monday, on Patriots Day, when I'm told up to 36,000 people line up to start the marathon, you will send a resounding message around the world, not just to the rest of the world, but to the terrorists, that we will never yield. We will never cower.
Three people died and more than 260 were wounded in that attack. And still to come on NewsWatch, CBN News heads to Boston for a look at how faith is leading to forgiveness in that city.
By 2016, the U.S. military must open all combat positions to women. The move will give females the opportunity to serve on the front lines for the very first time. But it seems not many women want the job. The most recent Army survey finds that only about 20% of female service members would choose to serve in a combat role. According to the Defense Department, women make up about 15% of the country's military. There are some women, however, who are stepping up to serve on the front lines, hoping to see military culture change.
And as Caitlin Burke reports, these women are proving to be top performers and leaders.
At Fort Bragg, North Carolina, First Lieutenant Kelly Requa is making history.
I mean, I think it's a good job.
At her base, Requa is among the first female platoon leaders.
We're a unit that likes to pride ourselves on embracing diversity. There was no discussion really at all. Once she got there, the discussion stopped.
Ahead of the January 2016 deadline for all combat jobs to be open to women, scientists are studying the physical demands of being on the front lines, measuring strength, endurance, power, set benchmarks regardless of gender.
We want the best talent that we can possibly get. And these are exactly the same standards that we expect soldiers in basic training and in units to perform to each and every day.
Requa welcomes the challenge. She says that even though the guys in her platoon are stronger, in physical training, she can keep up no problem.
Anybody can be a platoon leader. Anybody can be a crew member as long as you can do the job.
For now, she's the only woman in her platoon. But later this spring, women will begin serving as crew members. Their job? Actually position the 4,000-pound cannons, zero in on the targets, and fire the rounds. For men, the integration of women into combat roles means a new focus on respect, team building, and sexual assault prevention. So far, Requa says there haven't been any problems. And more often than not, it seems the men in her platoon forget she's the only woman on the field. Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
The top Democrat on the panel investigating the IRS targeting scandal is being accused of possibly playing a role. Congressman Elijah Cummings has complained about Republicans investigating former IRS official Lois Lerner. Now, House Oversight Committee Chairman Daryl Issa is releasing evidence against Cummings. New agency emails show Cummings' staff may have coordinated with the IRS to go after a conservative group called True the Vote. It was one of the same groups targeted by Lois Lerner's IRS division.
Turning overseas, no one is claiming responsibility for Monday's massive bombing that killed more than 70 people in Nigeria's capital. But the country's president says all evidence suggests the attack in Abuja was the work of the terrorist group Boko Haram. Gary Lane has more.
Monday morning's bombing was the deadliest ever to hit the Nigerian capital of Abuja. The massive explosion occurred at a bus station during morning rush hour, killing at least 72 people and injuring 169 others. This man witnessed the bombing and says he initially thought a fuel tanker had exploded. Boom! Nigerian Victor Oladokun, CEO of 3D Global Leadership, was in Abuja at the time of the attack. He says a fearful, somber mood prevails in the capital city because no attack has occurred there for the past 4 years.
There has been a sense that Abuja is secure. Abuja is pretty much impregnable. That sense of hope and that sense of anticipation has been shattered right now.
Some people speculate the bomb was hidden in the ground. That's because the blast left this crater more than 4 feet deep and spread hot shrapnel across a wide path, slicing into the flesh of nearby commuters. But government investigators insist a suicide car bomber caused the deadly explosion. Oladokun says most Nigerians believe the attack was the work of Boko Haram terrorists.
What is a little bit disconcerting, I guess confusing for a lot of Nigerians at the moment, is that there's no rhyme or reason to all of the attacks.
And this bombing indicates that Boko Haram's terrorism may now be entering a new phase, one where public facilities are targeted, in addition to churches and schools.
We need to pray that peace will reign, that the attackers will be exposed and apprehended, and that sanity and peace be restored in Nigeria.
Gary Lane, CBN News.
Thanks, Gary. Coming up, an archaeological discovery involving the location of Jesus' trial before his death.
I have a son who's extremely smart and sensitive. He went to heaven. I came back.
One true story has become a worldwide sensation.
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Tomorrow, Heaven is for Real is a profoundly beautiful movie.
They don't read me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
That will help many to believe.
Is heaven a hope or as real as the earth and sky?
A perfect family film. Heaven is for Real. Rated PG.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need, just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions, just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card, just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
I have a son who's extremely smart and sensitive. He went to heaven. I came back.
One true story has become a worldwide sensation.
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Tomorrow, Heaven is for Real is a profoundly beautiful movie.
They don't read me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
That will help many to believe.
Is heaven a hope or as real as the earth and sky?
A perfect family film. Heaven is for Real. Rated PG.
A lunar eclipse called the Blood Moon mesmerized millions overnight. The moon crossed through Earth's shadow and took on a reddish hue between 2 and 4 this morning. I actually saw it around 3:15 here on the East Coast. There will be 3 more of these eclipses before October 2015, in case you missed this one. Well, according to NASA, seeing 4 lunar eclipses in a row is rare. Some biblical experts have attributed special significance to them since they coincide with Jewish feasts. And for more, you can watch Eric Stackelbeck's interview with Pastor John Hagee to hear his view of the history and potential implications of blood moons. And you can find that at cbnnews.com.
The exact location of where Jesus was sentenced to death has remained a mystery for 2,000 years. But a recent archaeological discovery in Jerusalem is causing some Christians to question their long-held theories. Gary Lane has more.
Each year, thousands of Christian pilgrims from around the world journey to Jerusalem for Holy Week. They walk down the Via Dolorosa, the route that Jesus walked on his way to the crucifixion. Near Mount Zion, they can view a remarkable archaeological discovery. In 1999, excavations around the Kishli prison revealed something massive. Buried beneath the Ottoman-era prison were the remaining walls of a great palace. Amit Riem is an archaeologist with the Israel Antiquities Authority.
The archaeological remains that we found in the excavation points to that this ground is the actual palace of Herod the Great. We have the retaining walls. It was a massive engineering project, and we see it in the excavation. We even found an enormous underground sewage that could only belong to the palace of Herod.
If it is Herod's palace, could it also be the spot where Jesus was tried? Some Christian historians believe his trial occurred in Herod's palace, while others insist he was put on trial at the Antonio Barracks Fortress. The Bible says Jesus appeared before Pontius Pilate at the Praetorium, his residence. But did Pilate reside at the palace or the Antonio Fortress? Christian archaeology professor Father Eugenio Aliata says it's possible the Praetorium was at Herod's palace. But he says the evidence must be more compelling if the Catholic Church is to abandon its long-held belief that the trial occurred at the Antonio Fortress.
Usually we stay with the last tradition we receive. And it is necessary to have a very strong argument in favor of an older tradition to go back to that.
While the Herod Palace discovery may change some views of the actual location of Jesus' trial, still unchanged is the actual reason for his conviction, crucifixion, and resurrection. Gary Lane, CBN News.
Up next, 1 year later, we visit Boston to see how people moving forward from the marathon bombing.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you are on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Today marks the anniversary of the Boston Marathon bombings.
Yeah, and while it was a tragic day for the city and the country, many are relying on their faith to help them move on.
Tom Buring brings us this story of forgiveness in tonight's Focus Report.
When Boston's marathon began in Hopkinton, runners were on their mark. But they would soon chase a great distance that would feel as deep as it ran long.
Well, the day started with a tremendous amount of anticipation and excitement. You've been training for 6 months, 6 days a week.
Went out to the site and started running the race. It was a beautiful day, Tom. It was a gorgeous day, and everybody was in great spirits.
Down the road, Fenway Park was packed. catcher Jared Saltalamacchia hit a home run, and his Red Sox rallied for a win.
We just finished the game, and we were in the clubhouse, got on the bus, and one of the guys just, you know, said, hey, there was a bomb at the finish line of the marathon, and then there was another one.
Rob Davis had just finished the 26-mile race. He was exhausted. He toweled off and ate, then waited to cheer on a friend near the finish line. After hearing the first blast, he was caught 20 feet from the second explosion.
The bomb went off right in front of us. People are screaming, and we've gone from a beautiful day in Boston to a war zone instantaneously. And I'm looking just across the street at a guy sitting in his chair with his legs blown off. I look down at my feet, and the bone of his leg are at my feet. At the same time, there's a girl that's on fire, and she's running towards me, and a police officer grabs her and starts patting down her hair. This girl is shell-shocked, freezing, naked, on Boylston Street. I start shaking. I'm shaking again. It just, you go back into this, and you got the smell of the gunpowder, you got blood everywhere, you got people screaming hysterically. And I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, God, how am I going to get to the point where I can forgive?
It's a question that still lingers, challenging many, including some of those who visit the recently restored sidewalk along the Boylston bombing sites.
The famed marathon of determination and achievement quickly changed, catching all of us flat-footed. It moved to a much different race, one with hurdles, hurdles of fear and forgiveness.
Sanjan Sharma was 5 miles away from the blast, at the bottom of Heartbreak Hill. That's as far as he got. Police stopped him and other runners as ambulances raced by. As a pastor and counselor, he's encouraging those who can't see past injustice.
And what I share with people is that's a bad place to remain. Resentment and bitterness becomes a place of comfort. It becomes a place where we like to stay. And like many have said, it becomes our own prison. And we cannot escape, and we cannot get beyond.
America's most beloved ballpark became a sanctuary of support and strength as the Red Sox helped brand the call for Boston to be strong. Jared's last name, the longest in Major League history, provides him with a reminder.
Saltalamacchia, it means to jump over a thicket. It's pretty cool because constantly that's what we're doing is we're jumping over something. We all come to a gap in the road in our lives that we need to, get over. For me, that's been a big thing where I don't want to cut my Christianity short. I don't want to cut my relationship with God short and cut corners. And I want to just be all in, just be all in for him. And, then I won't ever have to worry about that gap in the road. I always have him to help me get over it.
And this is where I believe our faith is so essential. If we look at Jesus, there's no one who's been wronged like him in the same way. And yet, he looks down at those who hurt him, and he's able to release. He's able to let go. His example helps us and guides us through the minefield of emotions that we go through.
Has your Christianity been tested?
Without a doubt, 100%. There's so much emotions built up through this whole ordeal. Just think about more than just yourself. And stop being selfish for that moment and what it truly means to be a Christian. And that's what everybody sees.
When evil comes at us, our response, the power in our lives, comes by being able to repay that evil and really undo that evil with blessing, with courage. And that's where I think we can overcome the fear, and that's where I believe we can overcome bitterness.
How do you process releasing forgiveness?
Going to these hospitals, seeing, I talked to a gentleman who was there with his 4-year-old son, and then that's when the second bomb went off, and that's when he realized that, his leg had, been blown off, basically. And the first thing he did was grab his son and just protect him. And then he called an officer over and told the officer, just take my son and protect him, keep him safe, put him wherever you got to put him. And I look at that and I say, that's what Jesus does to us.
Up next, how a tiny camera is working to teach people the realities of homeless life.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you are on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
And finally tonight, it's not always easy to put yourself in the shoes of those suffering around you.
And that's why One San Francisco Group is using video technology to offer a glimpse into the lives of the homeless. Adam Rickard has been homeless for 30 years. Recently, a group of sociologists picked him to be the center of the Homeless GoPro project. Every day, Adam documents his time on the streets using a GoPro video camera. The goal: show others the hardship of homeless life.
A lot easier to be, I guess, that way, best way to put it, is to be cold or, you know, have less feelings when you're typing something than when you look at someone in the eye. Average right now is like 40 hours of waiting in a line to get a bed for one night. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, people don't realize the stuff like that, you know, going get lunch, hour and a half, 2 hours.
At the core, what we're trying to do, get a better understanding of the stories, what's happening, so that we can innovate new ideas on how to use these services better.
The Homeless GoPro project aims to create more compassion for the homeless community. The project plans to release a new video every week. You can find a link to our website at cbnnews.com. Great idea.
Interesting. Yeah. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of NewsWatch.